Hey everyone, I'm Bhagat Gaur. In the previous video, I showed how you can convert any SVG file to a 3D model. But what if your client gives you just a normal image that is not an SVG and asks you to convert it into a 3D model? In this video, we are going to convert any 2D image to an SVG using Photoshop. You will encounter some problems while doing this process on your own. And you will not find any solution at the moment because I searched for them and no video on YouTube gives the proper solution to this. Watch this video without skipping so you can never look for another video regarding this problem. Let's get started. I have this poor quality logo that is in JPG format. If there is any background, please remove it because we want only the logo to be in 3D. Now we have the proper logo. If we import this into Blender, the model is going to look like this. We want the logo to be in individual pieces, so let's make the logo separate. The important part of this video is that the image we are working on are in pixel form. To make them smooth and export them as SVG, they should be in vector form, otherwise your model is going to look very bad due to too many curve points. In Photoshop, there is a faster method to convert any selection of an image to a vector with a few clicks. But remember, the automatic methods always end up with bad results. If you want it to be perfect, you can do it with the bend tool. Now we have different layers. Control left click to select the entire layer. Choose this rectangle tool. Then right click and choose make work path. Here, the higher the number, fewer the points are going to be, which will result in less detail. And if you go with a low number, you will get too many curve points, which are not required. You can control these points to be higher or lower inside Blender. So experiment with the number and choose the one that best fits your image. I'm sticking with the default value, which is 2. Before you do this to all of the layers, let me show you the tricky part. If you have the most recent version of Photoshop, you should be able to export this as SVG without issue. But some people are going to get blank transparent output. To demonstrate that, let me add a random shape here. Now go to File, Export, Export As, and select SVG. If you didn't find this SVG option, you can again go to File, Export, and Export Preferences. And here you will find a checkbox with the name Legacy. Just enable that and press OK. Now if you try to export it as SVG, the layers we have made are going to disappear. If you can find your layers, then you can hit export all, save it as SVG and use it in Blender. For people who get only transparent output, this is happening because the arrow we added is in shape. To make our vector layer to shape, go to this pen tool and select the shape. It will take the foreground color, but we shouldn't worry about that. You can change these colors in Blender. Now we have converted this into a shape. Apply the same process to all of the layers. After completing, you can export this as SVG without issue. File, Export, Export As, choose SVG and export it. The video is not over yet. I hope you learned how to convert your image to an SVG using Photoshop. If you have already watched my map video, you know how to export it into Blender and convert it into 3D. If you still want to know more, continue watching the video. After saving the SVG, open Blender, go to File, Import, and choose Scalable Vector Graphics SVG. If you do not find the option, go to Edit, Preferences, Add-on, search SVG, enable this Import Export SVG and save it. Now import the SVG we have made into Blender. Choose the file and hit Import SVG. To see the top view, hit 7 on the numeric pad or tap on this navigation. The origin point is at world's origin. To make it in center of every layer, first choose any layer, then select every other layer and press Tab to go into edit mode. Press A to select everything, hit G and bring it to the center. Now rotate the logo by pressing R, and to rotate it on the X axis, press X and type 90 to rotate it by 90 degrees. Now select any layer, go to the curve properties, and do you remember that I told you that you can control the points in Blender? You can do that from here. Just adjust this value. Now to extrude it, go to geometry and increase the extrude. To see this clearly, I'm changing the default material. And we can see that the edges are very sharp. Again, go to the curve properties and in the bevel section, increase the depth a little. You can hold the shift key to increase it very slightly. Extrude every layer according to your taste. I will just copy the same setting to the other letter. Just by clicking the letter, holding down the shift and selecting the extruded letter. Hover your mouse to extrude, right click and copy to selected. Do the same to bevel. Or you can extrude multiple objects at once by selecting one object, holding the shift key and selecting another object. While extruding, remember to hold the alt key to do the extrusion on both objects. I'm also holding the shift key to extrude it smoothly. After doing this to all of the objects, you can now add the materials. I'm going into render mode. Let me add an environment texture. In the materials, hit use nodes to view every option. I'm duplicating the material and choosing a color. Renaming my material to black. I'm adding the same material to other objects. Add a plane, a camera, and an empty. Change the plane material to something gray. Select the camera, turn on the depth of field, and choose empty as the focus object. Now, if you feel the logo is a little bit dull, you can do this. Select both letters, duplicate it with Shift D, go to curve properties, and change the fill mode to none by holding the Alt key to change for both letters. In the same way, increase the bevel by holding Alt key, also hold the Shift key to increase it smoothly. Now we added a nice edge to our objects. You can change its material to something like metal and increase the metal. decrease the roughness. If you like this look, you can do this to every object. Now we have best looking logo in 3D. I'm changing the material color to something like gold to give our model a premium look. This is how you can convert any image or logo to a 3D model using Photoshop. I hope you like it. Please subscribe to my channel for more videos, and if you have any trouble, comment down below. I'm happy to help you. Thanks for watching.